God is doing something in Iran. And it's so, and the church has been growing so rapidly that there are far away more than 1 million followers of Jesus in Islamic Republic of Iran. So the Church of Jesus is willing to be faithful and share the gospel no matter what the consequences are. And the brothers and sisters, this is what they say. If you just overcome your fear, when you are a believer, a disciple of Jesus, and you share what you have to any other Muslim in Iran, 100 out of 100, they want to receive Jesus. There's no opposition towards Jesus in Iran and in among the regular people. Of course, the little selected number, maybe 2% of the population who are brainwashed Muslims, they will oppose, but they are in minority. The Church of Jesus Christ is taking over Republic of Iran. And we are so excited about that. Just today, 6 Chinese Back to Jerusalem missionaries, they flew in to Armenia, to the capital of Armenia, to Yerevan. And 6 Iranian Christians flew from Tehran to same place. And they start from tomorrow morning, 6 o'clock. They start to go to the streets of Armenia because this is the Iranian New Year week. So there are hundreds of thousands of Iranians who will come to the neighboring country, which they know is not a Muslim country. And they want to breathe some fresh air. So they come as tourists for a week to Armenia, and now the gospel will reach them. Last year, this week, we saw 5,000 Iranians to kneel down literally on the streets, corners of Armenia, and they received Jesus as their Savior and Lord. And that has created an avalanche for the gospel of kingdom, because they got Jesus, and they became very radical from the beginning. And so when they back home, I got phone calls from cities like Tehran, Mashhad, and all these big 5 cities. And they said, brother, when can you come? We have 300 believers. Somebody have to come and baptize them. We don't have pastors. We don't have evangelists. But we have mighty Jesus. So if you want to have some adventure in your life, come and sign up with Back to Jerusalem, and I will send you to baptize people in Iran. Amen. So this is what God is doing right now as we think it's impossible. Iran is lost for the gospel. It's not. The God is building up his church. And what I'm sharing with you are the facts. It's not a missionary soft talk. This is the reality. I have been there so many times. I have seen it to happen. Now we have this challenge. As you remember, have I shared here about when we printed the Iranian Bible in China and we smuggled it? I'm not sure if I have shared that. But most of you haven't heard it. This is good. So when we came to contact with Iran, and I met with 150 underground church leaders, and I really want to honor these leaders who haven't taken the easy way fleeing to Turkey and from Turkey to west coast of United States. There is a tremendous Iranian population in this part of the world, but they are all, because of the persecution and consequences to be a preacher in that country, they have chosen for one reason or another. I don't blame them. But there are pastors still operating inside the country. I met with 150 of them and asked, what is your number one need? And they said, brother, tell to the believers in China, pray for us that we remain bold and we don't compromise the gospel of Jesus Christ. That was the only, nobody asked that. Pray that we would have easy life, we would have successful life, that we will not be in prison. Just pray that we don't compromise the gospel of Jesus Christ, because we believe there is power in the gospel of Jesus Christ. And this is what we've been doing. And they said, brother, is there anything practical we could do? And the brother said to me, brother, if you any way can help us, we have so high shortage of Bibles. Can you try to get us Bibles? And I said, now you are talking my language. I have printed over 13 million of Bibles in China in the before. So we have five locations. We can print anything from there and bring it here. And they said, wonderful needs. And then I asked, how much would you need? And they said, brother, we would need 1 million Bibles as soon as possible. And I challenged them. That time I did not know anything what was going on. I said, I have to come to Iran and check myself whether that's true. Because I told them that the people, the expert of mission towards Iran, they say that there are only 300,000 believers totally. So I felt that they're just, in case something would happen, they want to have more Bibles. But the brother said, no, that's the truth. That's the truth. We have over, far away, over a million disciples of Jesus Christ. And most of them, they don't have a Bible. So we did it in Chinese way. As you know, Chinese, they don't even know the word copyright. They just copy it right. So it was very easy to do. So I just took an Iranian Bible and I brought it to one of the biggest print houses in China and who had a good quality of paper. And we put leather cover on it. It was red. It was much nicer than this Iranian Bible I have with me today. We printed the name on it with golden letters, and it was really fancy. I just loved that Bible. And after they had printed, I brought it to the printing place, and because we are old customers, they've been printing a lot to us already before, I asked her, how long does it take to copy this right? And she said, 3 weeks. And I think that's the fastest for nothing. You don't even have the printing plates. You have nothing. And they did it in 3 weeks. 3 weeks later, I received all these containers, in fact, with Iranian Farsi Bibles. And then we went into the second plan. We have to bring them to the port of Shanghai. And the containers arrived to Shanghai. And then we have another lady who is a non-believing, good communist, very good cargo agent, and I approached her and I said, we have a special production coming to the port tomorrow, and it's a handbook, and there's one nation in this world where people are so hungry and so they need so much this handbook. Would you help me to get it as cheap as possible to Istanbul in Turkey? And she was so moved. She wasn't even a believer that she said, if that's the case, I will participate and I will send it free of charge. No cargo shipment. And all my containers were, I have never been involved in that cheap transportation. It cost nothing. And then we were in the port of Istanbul and we saw the containers coming. The customs, they didn't have any clue. Because it wasn't Arabic, so they didn't have any clue whatever this was. And so they took it into the country. I didn't have to pay any custom fees, because that was our little problem, because we didn't want to pay any VAT or any tax on those, because they were not staying in Turkey. Sure. Then we put everything on the trucks, and we travel all the way across Turkey to the Iranian border. And I am so thankful to the Lord that the Iranian border is like an old Swiss cheese. It has a lot of holes. And they were big enough to squeeze in the Word of God into Iran. And we did not lose even one Bible on the way. So everything went into Iran. And then we started to wait for good news from Iran. And 4 months later, I was so pleased when Friday night, 7 p.m., that was the best sending time. It's the beginning of the Islamic weekend. One of the two ayatollahs stood up in public television on primary time. And I was so thankful and praising God. He had one of our Bibles in his hand. So that night, 78 million Iranians, most of them first time in their lives, they saw the living Word of God. And then he said, look at this book. Very nice leather cover, golden letters. and everybody would like to read this book. But as your leader and the father of this nation, I forbid anyone to even look into this book. We have never got so good display for Word of God, because it literally backfired. Because this is what 78 million people heard, that this man who has caused all the misery of my life, 30 years of Islamic slavery, I am not a Muslim and I will never become a Muslim. But I have to pretend like I would believe everything like he said. And especially the women and young men and women, they are all rebelling against the Islamic leadership of the nation. If that man, who is the source of all the misery, says that something is very bad and it's not good to read, it must be good news. Amen. They are not stupid. Remember, these coming salvation candidates, they are not stupid. They know the difference between good and bad. So, as the whole nation started to cry for Bibles, and so we have to do it in Chinese way, and as I have been showing you before, here I have 50 Iranian Bibles in this little, and if I would take out one of them, those of you who are below age of 30, you still see, and I have something between my fingers, the older one, you just have to believe that there is something. This is a full-blown Iranian Bible. You can read it, you can listen to it, and there are 6 movies like Jesus film, How God Created the World, More Than Dreams, everything just in Farsi, enforcing the gospel into that nation. And the good news is that we have now in place these, what we call digital bread bakeries inside Iran. And they are spitting, they are able to spit out 100,000 Bibles a month inside Iran. And this is going to lay the foundation to that the remaining 77 million in Iran, they will hear the Word of God. God is good. And if there is God-given vision, God is in charge. And He will achieve it. He will make it happen. Yeah. It is just like Brother Mark said, we have to follow the wind of the Holy Spirit. Yeah. It's never a traffic light, it's a wind. Yeah. You have to remember, people are always praying, oh, I got the red light, I cannot go there. No, the Holy Spirit is the wind, and it blows wherever He likes. And it's for us to make sure that my sail is attracted by that wind, and I will move towards that direction He's leading. And from nation to nation, God is doing a new thing today. I have been a missionary almost 40 years now. I used to pastor a little church in Stockholm. We had only 6,000 members. And then I get sick and tired of all that counseling and all that. I felt, Lord, there must be more. I cannot solve people's marriage problem and their problem with their children and their financial problem. I said, Lord, do you have anything else in store? And Lord said to me, if you are crazy enough, I can send you to China. And it has been a learning curve, but it has been wonderful in that sense that 25 years ago, I met Brother Yun. And we discovered that there are also crazy people in China, and he's one of them, called Heavenly Man. So he fully accredited to be here with us today. Now I will close with this. The revival in China is just reaching deeper and deeper into the society. And it has become almost a trend that unless you are a believer of Jesus, I cannot even believe you, what you are saying. It has become, they understand that from the leadership on the highest level to the grassroots, people are lying 24/7. There's nothing you cannot trust your lives upon what they are saying. But if you meet a truly born again disciple of Jesus Christ, that is good news for your life. And that's the people. And that's why people are so attracted to the gospel. Every month, still today, after all these years of revival, over 1 million people make this decision. I want to follow Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. And I may have mentioned this before, but Mr. Xi became the president of China about 3 years ago. He received documents from the China Statistics Bureau. I have seen those documents, so I know that this is not fabrication. This is seeing is believing. And this is what he was presented. That, and I know the guy, he is a professor in Beijing University who was asked to go and do this survey about extension of Christianity throughout the People's Republic of China. And he came back with a report nobody want to read. Nobody want to believe, want to see, because it stated that there are at least 160 million followers of Jesus Christ in China today. And what do you think the president was thinking? He knows that there are 80 million members in the Communist Party. Somebody is taking over my nation. And then this same man, the professor from Beijing University, he said, if this goes on another 20 years, one out of three people living in China today will be attracted to the gospel of Jesus Christ. And that is a good 500 million people. So God is piling up something for his purposes. And that purpose is that the house of Buddha, the house of Hindu, with millions of gods, and the house of Muhammad are about to get the surprise of their lives when Jesus' name will be brought. And I so much bless you, Brother Mark, going to Nepal. I have to add this little sidetrack here. When there was earthquake in Nepal, we wanted to respond. And of course, the quickest way we could respond is through the Chinese missionaries who were already there. So within 24 hours, we started to get provision in and make sure it reached to the forest part of, not to Kathmandu, but to the countryside. So back to Jerusalem was there. 48 hours after the earthquake, another team of Back to Jerusalem missionaries come, and this is special. They are all Amish Mennonites. So we got Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob coming in. And they have been in Nepal since that time. They've been there almost a year now. And they are working together hand in hand with Chinese missionaries. And it has been just a great mission awakening among the Amish churches in Lancaster County in Pennsylvania and in neighboring countries. It has been an outpouring of the Holy Spirit, so that there have been literally houses in fire because of the presence of the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit, wherever he have access to the souls and hearts of the people, they got excited about mission. So they came to me and they asked, Brother Taisto, Brother Ren, how can we partner together? I said, there's only one way. Pick up your cross and follow Jesus. If you want to do that, they never even had a passport. You know, the Amish people are excluded from everything. They don't pay any taxes, but they don't get school, no medical care, nothing. They never are involved in any election. They are living totally in their own societies. So now they have to make the long way. How do you get a passport? Am I really a citizen of this nation? Do they approve it? But one by one, they receive this approval. And so far in last 18 months, over 120 Amish missionaries has been working with us throughout Middle East. So it looks like God is taking something which is nothing in order to glorify him. So just that if you receive, feel that I feel that God is calling me to do something, do not mislead yourself that you are special. You are just one of those nothing he's calling to follow him, so that he will be glorified in whatever you. So I will close here and we will continue. You get some more mission news in the evening meeting if you can still afford or want to come and join us tonight. God bless you.
Praise God. I'm going to get out of the way real quick for Brother Yun. He's on fire. I can feel it, okay? He's got a word to bring to you. So I want to give you an opportunity to give here. And, you know, just before I do, I just want to say this. Listen to your people. Don't lose any kind of confidence about what God is going to do in the United States of America. We've got too many missionaries on the field, too much money going there. And we're going to see something great take place here in this nation. Listen to me. If there's any great model, it would be China. And God took China and he wiped it as a man wipes a plate. 5,000 years of traditional religious practices, animism, all different things that went on there, and ancestral worship, etc. And now we have over 200 million Holy Ghost-filled Christians in the nation of China. Come on, give me a break. Come on. Over a million. Oh, listen, if the Lord's going to do it in China, and under the strong, you know, hammer and sickle of communism, I mean, what? Look, we're going to have another great outpouring of God, the Holy Ghost. I love what William Booth said. He said, "I'm not waiting for a move of God. I am a move of God."
Amen.
You listen to
Praise
me.
God.
William
Thank
Booth.
You.
I mean, just that's radical. I'm not waiting for a move of God. I am a move of God. I mean, I'm in total agreement with what God the Holy Ghost is about to do, you know, and what he's doing. And, you know, when Brother Yun and Brother Shi sent me to Nanyang many years ago, I thought, well, when I get there, what am I going to do, Lord? And I thought to myself, my, if I get there and find a church that's frozen over with a bunch of religion and tradition, I'm just going to be heart sick. Because when you got that many people, how can you get a vision to see 1.3 billion people, you know, touched by the fire of God in 1 week? You know, just like, you know, there's just no hope. And so I get there and I discover a church on fire. On fire with the Holy Ghost. The way God the Father designed it. Today in America, people try to create doctrines that exclude the Holy Ghost. But we're including him. We want just what he did in Acts 2:4 and don't want any doctrines that would somehow eliminate it. We want just what he did all through the book of Acts. We want the ministry of Jesus just like he modeled it and showed it. Don't want anything different. And we pray that you feel the same, because that's the only hope. That's how China changed. Just like men that you're getting ready to hear right now, filled with the word of God and the spirit of God, who are willing to pay the price. It didn't matter whether it was death, prison, what, it didn't matter. You know, just go in Jesus' name. And so today I want to encourage you. You get to go. Everybody gets to play a role in the move of God. I was just reminded recently of the Hebrides revival. An 82-year-old woman and an 84-year-old woman down on their knees praying and crying out to God saw a sweeping revival across the Hebrides. Hey, listen, you begin to participate with your relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. You are born into the kingdom of God to be able to have impact in the nations of the earth as you present something so supernatural to the throne room called your prayer. And we also get to participate in another way. We get to labor to help send them. And as Paul said in Philippians 4:16-17, not that I desire a gift from you, that I desire that you take care of me, but I want you through your giving to be able to participate with us, that we may have fruit on your account, that what we're doing, you're also doing it with us. And now listen, I'm going to tell you right now, praise God, we get to do this and give and participate with our giving, but that doesn't exclude you from going. It allows you just to get seated that much more and present yourself that much more before the throne room of heaven, saying, "Lord, I will go, send me." And he's crying out right now, the Spirit of the Lord saying, "Who will go for us? Who will go for us?" This is what the Lord is saying. If you would encounter God right now, which he wants, you would hear him saying, "Who will go for us?" And then if somebody's saying, "Well, I'm just unclean, I can't go," and start seeing all their lack and all their shortcoming and all their failure, he will do the work that needs to be done to impart the grace and provision for you within a moment. So that
Amen.
You can say, "I will
Amen.
Go." So
Amen.
All your excuses Amen. Are excluded.
Amen. Hallelujah.
All the excuses are gone. So I want everybody to stand with me so you can get out your wallet. Hallelujah. And I want you to do this. I want you to do this. We have envelopes with the ushers, please. If you're giving cash and you want to just keep track of your cash giving, we'll be happy to help you with that. So just raise your hand and someone will give you an envelope. And what we're going to do today, both today and tonight, we usually in the morning just take everything for Brother Yun and then take a receive an offering and tithes and offerings for the church in the evening. But what we're going to do tonight, today, is that this morning we're going to give you an opportunity to give in both ways. And we got people that will sort this out. Okay, just put on your memo that it's tithe. If you do not do that, it will all go to Brother Yun. Let me say that once again. Put on your memo that it is tithe. If it's not, if you don't do that, it's all going to Brother Yun. And then tonight, again, we would take an offering that will receive an offering that will be exclusive for Brother Yun Back to Jerusalem Ministry and all the things that they're doing in North Korea and Iran and Sudan, and the list goes on. And so we just are so blessed because, see, our heart is for 3 billion people have never heard the gospel. Say 3 billion.
3 billion.
I don't want you just to hear it. I want you to say it. That way you'll remember it.
Yeah.
About 3 billion people have never really seen and heard the testimony of the Lord Jesus Christ. And it is our responsibility. In fact, it is our pleasure.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's true.
To run with revival, to run with the move of God, to run with the word of God and the spirit of God. And make sure that everybody hears, because there are nations out there crying out. I'm getting ready to go into the territory of 40 million Pashtuns.
Yeah.
The Pashtuns believe that they're actually descendants from Ephraim,
yeah,
from the tribe of Ephraim, and they're in the Kashmir Valley in Srinagar and Jammu. And listen, their harvest is plenteous.
Man.
Harvest plenteous, labor's few. Say harvest. Is plenteous.
It's plenteous.
And the laborers are few.
And the laborers are.
I'm looking at millennials right now as they are flooding towards a new call and an identity in socialism and in communism right here in this nation, because they've not seen the glory of heaven. And I'm going to tell you right now, we're going to not only reach the unreached people groups of the world around us, the nations around us, but right here in our Jerusalem. Right here in our Judea, right here in our Samaria region. And listen, I'm telling you, if you do not have a missions plan, you get one this morning. I'm going to pray here in a minute, and I'm going to ask God to supernaturally fill you with the grace to have a missions vision, to get a
Amen.
Missions plan. You need to be involved in prayer and by giving and also by going in a missions plan, because that's why the Holy Ghost was poured out, so that we might minister the power of the resurrection and be witnesses of the resurrection in our Jerusalem, in our hometown, in our near neighboring town, in those states right beside of us, the Samaria, in the uttermost parts of the earth. So, Father, I thank you right now in your mercy and by your power that there
thank
is
you,
an
Lord.
Overflow of your presence in the life of every person standing here, that there's not one single person that will leave this place today without a burden for the nations and without a great compassion for
yes,
the lost.
Lord.
Father, that
yes,
they are
Lord.
Going to be willing to go
thank
everywhere.
You,
by every means possible, whatever means they
the
have,
Holy Spirit.
And preach the gospel. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Just before you come, I want to say this to you. A friend of mine who now he's got a great ministry. He's got one of the 4 buildings that still stand that were actually buildings in the 1700s that were used in the Great Awakening. And when he was 18 years old, he said, Lord, I want to do something. Show me how to do this. How do I get started in ministry? He opened up his refrigerator. He had 1 pork chop and 1/2 a potato. That's all he had. He didn't have anything else. He didn't have money. Just a kid. 18 years old. He had 1 pork chop and 1/2 a potato. Mm. He took that pork chop and that 1/2 potato and he heated it up. And he went outside and he found the first person on the street. He kicked him, said, here, I'm your new pastor. Hallelujah. And that's how he started his ministry. I'm telling you right now, you listen to me. God will wear, he will not just use you. He will wear you out.
Amen. Amen. That is so true.
And we listen, too long the few have done the work of the many. Too long the few have done the work of the many. It's now time for the many to rise up. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Not the M-I-N-I, the M-A-N-Y. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So come
Amen.
On. Come worship the Lord with your giving right now. We just all come up front. Let Jesus watch what we're giving, you know. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Brother Yun.
Amen.
Brother Yun. Taisto and Brother Yun.
Yeah.
Come on.
Amen.
Thanks to him, Brother Yang. Come on. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the name of Jesus. Say praise.
Praise
the name.
The name
of Jesus.
Of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say, Lord, I worship you.
Lord, I worship
Hallelujah.
You.
Hallelujah. Say song ling.
Okay. See song ling. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Don't be afraid. Jesus loves you.
好，我们边奉献边学习。 不要怕，耶稣爱你。
At the same time as you are bringing your offerings, we are learning some Chinese. You have to get ready for missions. So let's learn this. 不要怕，耶稣爱你。 Don't be afraid. Jesus loves you. Okay. 不要怕。 耶稣爱你，不要怕。耶稣爱你。
Hallelujah!
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 我们拍手。
Let's give all the glory to Jesus. Hallelujah!
对，我是天上人云弟兄。
As you know, they call me Heavenly Man, Brother Yun.
在我分享神放在我里面的话语之前。
And before I'm going to share the message that is in my heart, the Lord has given it to me, I will say something. I want to take this golden opportunity to introduce my dear son Isaac, who is here, and his wife Fabiana, who are here.
Hallelujah, 站起来呀。 先不要坐下, 先站着。 Hallelujah. 他是我第一次在监牢的时候, 他出生的。
Isaac was born when I was already run into the prison first time in 1980s in China.
当我从监牢里面放出来的时候, 他已经5岁了。
And when I was released from the prison a few years later, Isaac was already 4 years old.
我非常感谢神, 这次汤牧师, 我们一起奉耶稣的名, 做见证在最后一道聚会的时候，我的儿子、媳妇他们一起来看望，不但看望爸爸，也是非常看望马可牧师或这里的弟兄姊妹。
And I'm so thankful that it worked out that Brother Isaac and his wife, who are studying in the Bible school in on the other side of San Francisco, they came to see us, and then they wanted to join us today to be in these two meetings in San Diego.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
我想在这里邀请伊萨上来跟弟兄姊妹有几句话，有神的话给弟兄姊妹。
And I want to give Isaac a few minutes. He can just greet you and share something from his heart.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Isaac, 你可以来。 Hallelujah.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Yeah. So this morning I spoke with Uncle Taiso. I say, every time if I speak and preach in English, the very first things what a church can receive is a boldness. Because I start to speak in English just a little bit more than 1 year ago. So
Amen.
God is faithful.
Amen.
So there's two marks. My father always spoke to me. He said, there's one pastor mark in the south, in the Southern California. There's another mark is in the pastor of the International Prayer House. This is the two men in the United States my father talked to me at most. Yeah. So they are my dear friends. Yeah. One day, my son, you have to know him. They have a great heart for China and for the kingdom. Mm-hmm. I'm so honored today to know this family. I have been there before, but I feel the Holy Spirit. Amen. The same spirit like in China, the same spirit like in Germany, like the place wherever I go. So this is my wife, Fabiana, and she's from Brazil. So I have a very international marriage. So I'm Chinese, I'm married in Brazil, we speak at home German. There's one lady called Xiao Min. She was 14 years old in China. She was in the church of my father. And my father saw the anointing on this little girl. She had an anointing for worship. My father bought her the very first voice recorder. You know, 35 or 40 years ago, this is very expensive for a farmer. And she lost this voice recorder. My father bought her the second and told to her, "My daughter, don't give to anyone this voice recorder. Use this to record a voice from the Lord. He's going to give you worship songs." And this lady, she started just 4 years in the school, never studied music, never know how to sing. But while she was cooking or working in the field, the Spirit of God come upon her life, and she started singing. And every time if this happens, she takes a voice recorder and record a voice. Until today, there's over 2,500 songs she already wrote. More than that, I think this is the only one, the first human in the Christian history who wrote the most songs of worship. And with these songs, a revival, awakening, come to China. Pastor Derek Prince said, if you come to a place, you just listen to the worship, and you will know how deep God already worked in people's heart. You can preach, you can do different speech from your study, but you can only worship God from the deepest place from your soul. So why I tell this story? A very little girl with not so much gifting in life, and God used her to bring big revival to China. I say this because this is my another father. This is my uncle. This morning while I was showering, I think about that in this whole world, outside Jesus, there's no another man who takes so much care of my family, like a pastor, like Uncle Taiso. He's the only one. He's a faithful friend to my father, but he's also become a faithful friend to mine, and also to my family. And he's more than an uncle. He's another father, just looks like different. And in this place, in this home, and before you and before God, I really want honor this man of God. And I know him a little bit more than maybe all of you. And he sometimes, you know, if people are getting older, he on there hurts. There's and many pains, but he never gave up to serve the Lord. Never give up to take care of the Chinese church, especially take care of my family. And even my wife and I, we study here in the United States, so we need a lot of food. I love to eat. I have many friends. And Uncle Taiso take care of my sister and my brother-in-law, they are missionary in Cambodia, and in the same way. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Isaac.
Hallelujah. In the same way, I want to say thank you to Pastor Mark and to this, your whole precious family, also the church family. Thank you. Pour out your love, your money, apart from you, to the mission in China, but also to another part of the world. You know, once give money is not just give money. This money once used maybe for drugs, maybe for pornography, maybe used for different stuff. And this money come to you. And you decide, Lord, I give this money, sending them to the war to win souls, Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
And the missionary from Norway come to China. She spoke a little bit Chinese. Preached many, many stories wrong. So I think you hear the stories. Mm-hmm. But my grandmom come to Christ. And my father come to Christ. And today he's traveling with Pastor Taiso through the world in different parts of the nations to preach the gospel, to see Townsend and the Townsend people come to Christ. They started only with one lady. Her name is Maria Marison from a very little Lutheran church in the very north part of Norway. Thank you so much for sowing money, sowing love, sowing attention to the mission. I'm not just talk about China, but sowing to the missions. One day if we come to the Lord, we will see how much our life, our giving, impart the kingdom of God. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's give a welcome to Jesus and glory to his name. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
I will use the words of John, the apostle, to greet you, as he wrote down in Book of Revelation, chapter 1. I am John, your brother and companion in the suffering and kingdom and patient endurance that are ours in Jesus. Today is the day of the Lord. It's Sunday.
当主日，约翰被圣灵感动，他听到一个大的声音在他后边说：“你现在把你所看见的，把现在的事都写下来。”And
it's written in the Bible that on the day of the Lord, John heard the voice of the Lord saying to him, "Write down everything that you hear."
我想问。 有多少人和我一样的相信这本新旧约圣经，包括启示录在内，是神的话，主的话，句句都是真实的。
How many of you believe like myself that the whole Bible, including the Book of Revelation, are living word of God, and it's the truth, and it's real? Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
启示录这卷书对我来讲是太重要了。Revelation.
Is the book of Revelation is the most precious book for me personally.
我认识耶稣的时候, 对启示录这卷书没有什么概念。
Now, when I became a believer of Jesus, I didn't have any clue about the book of Revelation. I had no relationship with the book of Revelation.
因为西国的宣教士把最简单的福音, 我就是传递给我的家乡。
And the reason to this that the missionaries, with their limited Chinese, they were only presenting a very simple gospel to the people in China. And then when the 80s communist regime came to power in China, all the missionaries were expelled. I know that my personal story, I have shared it so many times that you memorized my whole story.
可是，虽然宣教士离开了中国，但是福音的种子却是在中国。Now,
what actually really happened in China was that the missionaries disappeared, but the seed of the gospel remained in the Chinese soil, in the hearts of people.
虽然当时没有圣经了，但是神的爱没有离开中国。And
there were no Bibles in China. It was not preached anymore. But the love of Jesus and the Holy Spirit were operating all over China.
我想告诉弟兄姊妹，我们爱神实在是神先爱了我们。
Same happened in China like in our lives. We do love the Lord because He first loved us so much.
我的哥哥在惊慌中饿死以后，妈妈就已经陷入绝望，然后父亲又得到癌症，我的妈妈真正看不到未来了。
As you remember from my story, first during the great starvation, my oldest brother starved to death. And not long after that, my father became very sick, and he was told only have 2 weeks to live because of terminal cancer. And my mother lost all the hope of survival.
在一次最绝望的黑夜，我的妈妈再一次与神相遇。
And my mother, when she had decided to suicide on the lowest point of her life, no hope and no future, once again she had an encounter. She met the resurrected Lord Jesus.
我的妈妈就是听到很简单的说：“孩子，不要放弃，回家吧。”
My mother heard very clearly the Lord saying to my child, don't give up. Come back home. Jesus loves you.
妈妈跪在地上哭，然后把我的哥哥姐姐一同叫起来，孩子们跪下来为你的爸爸祷告。
So my mother kneeled down by the chair and reconciled her life with the Lord. And then came to us children, it was past midnight, and woke us up and said, we have to start to call upon the name of Jesus.
我永远不会忘记 我的哥哥和我一起第一次，就是人生第一次跪在父亲那个床前，
I never forgot what happened that night as my mother, and we surrounded our father's bed and we were kneeling and praying first time in our lives.
其实没有讲什么，我只说主啊，我耶稣啊，我不知道你是谁。如果我父亲好了，我愿意把我的生命给你。
And my first prayer of my life was, Lord Jesus, I don't have a clue who you are, but I need my father. If you healed my father,Father, I will serve you the rest of my life.
我那个简单的呼祷告声音触动了爸爸的心，我看见父亲在流泪。
And when we were praying this simple prayer and cry out to God, our father was moved, and first time in our lives, we saw tears running from his eyes.
我的姐姐和我的哥哥，我们围绕在爸爸的身边，扶着他。爸爸，不要怕，耶稣会救我们，耶稣会救我们，你不会死的。
And we as children, we were so moved. My older sister said, "Can you see, Father is crying?" And we said, "Father, don't cry. Jesus will rescue you. Jesus will restore you."
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
过了一个礼拜，我的父亲就这样完全地脱离了死亡的枷锁。
And God answered that.Prayer. Within 1 week, my father was not only healed, but fully restored from terminal cancer.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我十七岁遇见耶稣的时候，他呼召我就是要传福音做见
证。So about a year later, when I was 16 years old, the Lord came to me and he said to me one night, Brother Eun, stand up and preach the gospel and be my witness to west and south.
那是我对耶稣的认识。
My understanding and knowledge about Jesus was very limited, because I only been a believer less than a year.
那就是奉耶稣的名，病会好，鬼会跑。
I knew that if you pray in the name of Jesus, the sick will be healed and the demons will run away. That was very, I have seen it happen.
信了耶稣以后，家庭的问题就没有了。
And I was saying to everybody, if you believe in Jesus, that will be the ultimate solution for all the problems in your family.
所以说，上帝呼召我那年，我都是到处来做见证，这就是恩典和医治的福音。
So the first year in the ministry, I was preaching about grace of God and solution to your problems. That was my gospel.
我告诉弟兄姊妹，那一年最少有3000个家。
And I tell you, it was very favorable message. Over 3,000 people responded and came to Jesus because of those simple messages.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
可是有一样。事情我真的不懂的。
But there was one thing I could not understand.
就是跟随耶稣需要背起自己的十字架，需要。
What it really means that to deny yourself and follow, pick up your cross and follow Jesus, I didn't have any clue about this.
我今天要跟弟兄姊妹分享的信息，不单单是恩典医治的福音，乃是要跟随耶稣做主的门徒。
So that's why my message this morning is not a message about receiving more of grace of God. It's instead of how to respond God's calling to become a disciple of Jesus Christ.
当我开始带领很多人认识耶稣的时候，我17岁那一年陪着我的母亲被捆起来，然后带上棒棒的游戏。
When I saw all these people were coming to Jesus, so together with my mother, they capture us and they handcuff us for public display.
然后就这样开始我的人生旅途，就开始被追捕，7年以后。
And that was kind of a reality in my ministry. For the first 7 years or so, I was always a wanted criminal. They were chasing me and just about to catch me, but I was able to move away. If there's a persecution in this city, I did not stop preaching. I just moved to another city and I started it all over there.
就是天天都是要讲道了,
and I was like a 24/7 preaching machine. I was just preaching and preaching and preaching.
一天突然间我听到主开始对我说, 云弟兄, 你真的很累了，我要带你去休息。
And one day the Lord said to me something amazing. He said, Brother Un, I see that you are burning out. You are really exhausted. I will bring you to a place for a vacation, for a rest.
我不知道什么这个休息是什么，我认为可能神给我预备一个度假的地方，一个休息的地方，灵修的地方。我没有想到，原来是一个监牢在等待。
I was thinking that the Lord is going to send me to vacation, to a vacation home, where all my needs are met and I'm going to have a very wonderful time together with the Lord. I didn't have a clue that he was sending me to Chinese prison.
所以当我把那些信耶稣的人愿意跟随耶稣做门徒的人聚到一起开始背圣经。
So I called together my closest friends and I called them together and we started to memorize the Bible together in our first attempt to have a discipleship training.
当时 圣经在中国就好像现在伊朗伊拉克一样，都是缺乏圣经的。我们就是来抄圣经，然后大家背词来用。And
those years in early 1980s, there was so lack of Bibles in China, like it is today in North Korea, in Iran, in Iraq, Saudi Arabia, many of these countries. So we only have few copies of the Bible. So somebody was reading, and all the others started to memorize the Word of God.
然后背圣经的时候,
and as we were memorizing the Bible,
神就开始在我的里面开始，那个神那个灵就开始透过他的话语一直在充满,
and you
我有很多的诗歌开始要唱歌。
And God started to move in my spirit through all this memorize of the Bible, and there were songs that were birthed, and I started to sing songs according to the written word of God.
我想你们读过《天上人》这本书，你会了解那有其中一首诗歌叫《为主寻道》。Those
of you who have read my life story, Heavenly Man, you remember that the Lord gave me a song that day that get ready to die for the gospel of Jesus Christ.
不但为主传道，我愿意为主寻道，跟随耶稣。
And I was singing, Lord, I have made preparations. I'm ready to die for the gospel in China.
当我把圣灵感动我的诗歌唱出来的时候，很多人抱到一起哭啊，说主啊， 云弟兄为主寻道，我们愿意也为主去寻道。
And when I sang that song, sing that song first time, the Spirit of God was moving upon those young people. They were hugging one another in tears and said, we are also ready, if needed, to die for the victory of gospel in this country.
弟兄姊妹，我们唱是一回事，跟着唱是一回事，你个人的经历又是一回事。
Now, it's one thing to sing songs like this, and it's totally different to walk through these situations in your life.
我们聚完会就是要分散在不同地方，要去传道的时候，突然间公安把我们包围了。
So the reality hit just next evening. And suddenly the authority surrounded the whole place, and we started to enter into that situation in our lives.
那个时候我才第一次感受到，受到一个生命中受到威胁。我是一个当时被通缉的一个人。
And first time I really understood that there's a life danger for me in this situation. They've been chasing me for 7 years, and now they got me, and this is dangerous.
在这之前也抓过很多次，没有这么严重的。这一次是把我们所有的人捆起来。
I had been arrested 30 times before, but always been able to escape. But now they really solid, they got hold of me.
我就大声地喊叫，耶稣啊，你在哪里？耶稣啊，你在哪里？我们都被抓了。
And I thought that Jesus does not know this, so I shouted loud, Jesus, where are you? Don't you see that they have arrested us?
当我呼喊的时候,
and as I was calling my agony and fear to the Lord,
在我的内心深处突然间涌现出来一个不要怕,
and I heard the very strong voice of the Lord saying to me, don't be afraid, I know.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
这几个字你 我感受到这是神对我说的话。
And I recognize it's only Lord who can speak like this in the situation like this.
不要怕。
Don't be afraid.
不要怕。
Don't be afraid.
不要怕。
Don't be afraid.
我知道。
I know.
我知道。
I know.
这个话语在我的里面一直回应。
It started to roll around my being. And
当时我就开始那个惧怕没有了。
My fear disappeared.
那警察就问到一些人，你是什么人？老实交代是什么人？
And the police captain who was questioning us, he said, who are you?
我说天上人。
And that's when I first time said my name. I'm heavenly man.
天上人住在什么？
Where do you live, heavenly man? And I said, heavenly man lives in the village of Gospel.
他问父亲，我说父亲是满恩典，我的妈妈叫姓王爱。
And then he asked about my father and mother. My father's name is Phil of Grace, and my mother is Hope, Faith, and Love.
你家里还有什么？我说有哥哥，有弟弟，妹妹。他叫什么名字？
And then I have brothers and sisters. What are their names?
我说哥哥叫王珠来，弟弟叫穆文贤。
My brother's older brother's name is the king is coming back. And then I have a younger brother who have a deep desire of the returning of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
当时警察说这个人是个疯子，先把他铐起来关下去。
They had never heard anybody with names like this. They said, this man is crazy man. He's dangerous for society. We have to bring him to prison.
Now,
I have shared this so many times.
所以我在监牢里的时候,
So a few months into my first imprisonment, my son Isaac was born outside. I was 100% certain that in this world, in this time, I'm never going to physically see my son.
在当时的中国政府，你是反革命首要分子，是一个反革命骨干领袖的话了，那个就是无期徒刑到无期徒刑。
I knew that the communist regime, if they announce that somebody is a contra-revolutionary guerrilla leader, that person will rest of his life be in the prison or going to be executed. There were only two options for me. So I wrote a letter when the message came to me that my son has been born. I wrote a letter, I thought that that's the last letter to my newborn son.
我只是告诉他，爸爸是因为为了信仰，爸爸没有犯罪。
And I started my letter, my son, I'm in a prison for sake of the gospel and my personal beliefs. I'm not a criminal. I have not committed any crimes.
神让我给他起个名字叫伊撒。
And the Lord, that's where his name came about. The Lord gave me this name and I said, you are going to be called Isaac.
我趴在神的面前，我说神啊，我没有任何东西给你了，我愿意把我的儿子交给你。
And as I was on my knees in my solitary cell, and I said, Lord, I have nothing that I can give to you. And I said, Lord, I will give my son Isaac for you and for your kingdom purposes.
今天你们能够看到意思啊, 我是告诉弟兄姊妹, 你把你最宝贝的交给神, 他会超出你所想,
And I'm so happy that Isaac is here as a living testimony. If you are willing to keep the most precious treasure of your life, to, you see how that God is going to reward you.
Hallelujah. 第一次在监牢里面四年, 又外面又执行两年。
And then they got short of my sentence, so after 4 years, they released me from prison. And then I was in freedom 2 years.
我这四年将要结束,
now, when these first 4 years in the prison started to became to the end, and they have announced that that a certain day I will be released from the prison.
那时候那个四年那个监牢里那个劳改生活劳动改造，那个真正是一天到晚，你一点空档的时间呢，把你所有的精力都用尽了。
And it had been a lot of suffering and a lot of hard work and all those years, every minute of the day was filled with burdens.
将要被释放前的一百天,
so when it was only 100 days left of my imprisonment,
当时有一个人叫格里涵, 他就是找着徐永宅, 然后找到一些访问中国的时候, 他就写了一封信。
Now, it so happened that that time, Billy Graham was getting ready to come to China first time. And he had heard that some pastors are in prison. So he had written a letter questioning how are they dealing and treating a Christian in the prison. And that letter came to Peter Hsu, and they put it inside a steam bread, and they brought it to prison for me to read.
很简单，他们就是这些国外的一些祷告的人，想要了解中国的基督徒在监牢里的生活。
Their purpose was very innocent. They just wanted to know so that they intellectually can pray better for those pastors who are in prison.
没有注意到我真真实实地把这些都写出来的时候，后来公安呢就把所有的信件收走了。
I did not say anything difficult, dangerous in this. So very honestly, I write a reply to Billy Graham about how they are, what they are doing with me as I'm in a prison.
一天晚上，突然之间。 来掉一些这个公安这些警察，就是把我们的头包起来，然后戴上手铐。I
did not know that when that letter was supposed to be carried out from the prison, they got it at the security. So a few days later, close to midnight, a big number of policemen, they raided my cell. They had a black fabric they put back. They put it on my head. They handcuffed me and put me in chains.
那我不知道是为什么会有这，当时我完全不知道。
I didn't have a clue why they are doing this to me.
我说我再有三个月多一点，我就可以释放自由了。
In my mind, 3 more months and I'm going to be free. Why are they treating me like this?
突然之间，他们就这样黑夜之中转来转去，把我放在一个监狱里。
And then they were leading me. I was in complete darkness. I didn't know where are they. I just felt we are going down, down, down. And finally, they brought me to the very cellar, to the solitary confinement cell in the basement of the prison.
那是一个在监牢里面的隔离神学，那个监狱有5000人。
And there were 5,000 prisoners, but then none of them were usually in that little tiny cell, like a wardrobe, and it was deep down in the cellar.
我深夜之中在那个监号是一个人，我就在那儿大声喊，我说这个地方，朋友们，你们谁告诉我这是一个什么地方？我是某某人，我是天然人，
it was completely dark. There was no light in the entire department, and I was there alone. I was shouting, friends, is there any other human beings here? What is this place? I have no experience. I don't know. What is this ice cold place?
没有一个声音,
but there was no sound replying anything. I was all alone in my solitary cell.
那时候轮流都是一天呢, 经常给你两次稀饭。
And the only way for me to know that a new day has come, because in the morning According to their practice, they brought a bowl of watery rice and they gave it through that little door opening in the door. And in the evening, they came back and they gave the same kind of water rice, a little bit for me to eat.
I
really wanted to know what is this place and why I am here.
后来在神寻的时候，神， 我觉得那种神就是用不同的方式让我来做出一个决定去为主寻道。
And then after I had been there for a while, I said, Lord, I am not going to take this anymore. I'd rather die than stay alive in this situation. I want to die for the gospel of Jesus.
这些人他们用威胁的方式，他们说你的罪名，你离通外国，在监牢里面传道。
And as they were bringing me to the integration, the questioning, and they were asking, you are really dangerous. You have been in contact with the foreign nations, and it's a conspiracy against the Communist Party.
你不要想到是你4年就可以从监牢出来了。
And they said, forget your dream about 4 years in the prison.
我告诉你，你这个罪性按到现在。 在监牢里通外国把东西要，这个是死刑。如果你老实交代你的问题是怎样，透过谁，也许你可以是无期徒刑20年。
And this is what they say. This crime is really, really bad. And they said that you are going to be executed because of this. You have reported internal matters of China to another nation. But if you tell us who brought you this information from outside, then you may be still alive, and you will be in the prison for the rest of your life.
那个神寻的人，我认为他太笨了。他认为这样的一吓唬、一威胁，我会把老实的交代问题。
Now, that policeman, he was not so smart. He thought that by threatening me with death, it would make any difference that I will become a bird singing names of people that I'm connected with.
当他一开始说这个判死刑，最少 你将来你交代的好了好了，最少20年的时候，无期徒刑快20年的时候。
And but when he said to me, we're going to execute you, or if you behave and you confess your sins and you reveal the network of names, you will be having a life sentence, or maybe even possibly that after 20 years we will release you.
我当时虽然戴上手铐、戴上脚镣，我都把那个帽子丢到那衣服那个甩开。我说我现在要死的，我不会再告诉你们一句。我真的想死的。
Then I put away the black hood on my head, and I just shouted out, "It's no use for you to threaten me because I'm already ready to die for Jesus."
你们想杀将吗？反正我不想20年，也不想无期徒刑，我就是想死的。我现在请求你们成全我。And I said, you say, I
have no interest to be with you 20 years. If you have decided to kill me now. I'm ready.
他们神寻的人看完全没有办法，真的一点办法都没有。
And they lost their weapons. How do you treat and threat somebody who is already ready to die?
后来他们过了很长时间。And
then after a long time.
然后再跳，我说为什么？我已经做出一个决定，我要死的，没有。
And I was telling to them, how is it possible that I'm still alive after so many days? You say that you're going to execute me, and I've been just waiting that day, and I'm still alive. What's wrong with you?
后来他们没有一点办法了。
And after they didn't have any ways to get under my skin.
这些公安神寻人员他们也坐到一起开会。They
started. They had an internal meeting about my impossible case.
他们就把我的案件放到那，先不要管他，先搁到监牢里面饿他。And
they decided, let's keep him in that solitary confinement, and he's going to self die. We don't give him food, no light, and he will die there, and we get rid of this problem. But I had already made up my mind and make a decision.
我说主耶稣啊,
Lord Jesus,
我现在想要知道这个地方到底是一个什么地方。
I want really sincerely know what is this place and why I am here.
因为神寻是在一个小房子里面，跟外界完全隔绝的，看不到任何标志。
And even the location where they're questioning me, it was separated from the prison. So I didn't have see anybody else except those men who were torturing me.
请你告诉我,
and I was very, I wanted to know that the Lord would reveal me what is this place.
我其实问你要,
and I said to the Lord, Lord, I'm only actually missing one thing. You have to give me a Bible to this place.
我从前我刚认识耶稣的时候，我借去祷告，你把一本圣经。
And I reminded the Lord that many years earlier, after 100 days of prayer and fasting, I received my first Bible supernaturally.
我现在我知道这个不会难住你，因为你是神呐。
And I reminded to the Lord, this is not difficult for you. You have done this before, so why don't you bring a Bible to me so I can read the Bible?
我在监牢里有一个禁食祷告求圣经的计划。
So I had the golden opportunity to start to fast and pray in order to receive a new Bible to myself.
也没有人知道，你每一天来给我祷告的同学，我就拿到了祷告。
And nobody could see what was happening. The little rice came every morning. I thanked Lord for the rice, and I just pulled it down into the drainage. I didn't touch the food. I was 100% without eating and drinking in myself.
我现在求的就是你能够给我一本圣经。
And I said, Lord, can you see what's happening here? I'm this serious about to receive the Bible, so hurry up.
我每天都分，就是那个监牢里面也没有灯光，什么都没有，一个小小的一个洞。
And there was no light. When the day was, there was a little hole in the wall, and from that little spring, I could see, I could know when there is light on somewhere far away.
一天过去了，一天。
And days just went by, and no Bible arrived.
我感谢神，他们这个神巡人也不来神巡我，也。But
I was so thankful because they gave up. They didn't torture me anymore. They felt that there's nothing they can do. So I was all alone. Nobody disturbed me. I was alone in my solitary cell.
一天晚上，我在那个禁闭室，监狱的禁闭狱神相遇了。
And one night, I finally met with resurrected Lord again. He walked into my cell.
我在监牢里面有一个梦，我梦中我看到我从监牢的里面。 怀得自由了，手铐脚镣都脱落了，
and I saw a vision or a dream, and that dream was about the moment when I am released from my handcuffs and my chains, and I completely restored from my situation.
当我醒来，啊，那个时候兴奋呐，在那个监牢的那个梦中，
I was so excited in that dream, and I was almost flying.
我在告诉一个和我一起坐监的一个神父。 那我说，哎呀，感谢主！我在监牢的时候，我祷告神真的送我一本圣经。
And later on, I shared to brothers. I said that I was so happy about that. In a dream, I saw myself sharing to the Catholic bishop who was in the same prison how God miraculously gave me a Bible as I was in the cell.
他正和我一起感谢神的时候，突然间发现我还是在监牢里。
And in the dream, he was praising God for my Bible. I was praising God for my Bible. And then I woke up and I discovered I'm still alone in my solitary cell.
可能我们中间没有人做过那种监牢，那种监牢是对待人真正是一个折磨的。你的头抬不起来，你的腿是伸不开的。
It's impossible for you even imagine. I mean that the hole it was so low that I couldn't stand up straight, and it was just 4 square feet where I was standing. I could not sleep. I had to, everything happen inside that little cold, icy cold hole in the cellar.
当我醒来的时候，看见手铐还是在铐着。
So when I woke up from the dream, I said, "No, but it's not real. I'm still the handcuffs are still here."
我就开始说主啊，那这个我这梦也是从你来的。你叫你，我做梦，你叫你，你会，我的梦是属于你的。我究竟我什么时候能得到自由？
And I said to Lord, I believe that that dream was coming from you, and you showed it. And Lord, but how is it possible that I'm still handcuffed? And in these chains.
我感受到神真正很奇妙。我相信每一个相信他的人， 真正敬畏神的人，神真正给他身边派的有天使围绕。
And I believe, and I believe, and I experience that it's true that the Bible says that the angels are serving servants for those who are committed to the Lord.And God sent an angel to me.
我感谢神，竟然有一个人开始拍我说：“你的手铐可以开了。”
And I felt the angel saying to me, "You are all free. Just take off the handcuffs."
原来我进到监牢的时候，这个手铐铐得很紧。可是每一天我不吃饭，
But you know,
已经很长时间，我就是已经受力。
For a long time, I've been fasting without food and water, and you know, I started to shrink. So in the beginning, they were very tight.But now they had already become very loose, so I was able just to shake off the handcuffs.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
所以我的手铐和脚镣都可以脱落了。
And I was able to get me free from the shackles in my feet and handcuffs on my hands. I was completely free in my cell.
我能够真正经历到那个真正的自由啊！我要在地上给耶稣来打跟头来滚呐！
And I was on my knees. I was crawling because I couldn't stand up in the cell. And I was praising God. And I was almost wild before the Lord of that miracle.
Hallelujah.
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 过了一会儿，我就说：“那主啊，那我的圣经在哪里？”
And then after a little while, I said, "Lord, but in that dream, you showed me that I have a Bible in my hand. So where is the Bible?"
哎呀，你知道弟兄姊妹那个在那个监牢待自由的时候，你禁止不住的要唱啊！你大声唱也没有人管。
When you are set free from those handcuffs and shackles inside the prison, it was a non-stop praise and worship to God. My God is mighty, and I'm free. Hallelujah.
那个时候在监牢里，我最喜欢唱的诗歌就是说的：每一步越走越光明，像攀登黄金阶梯；每重担越跳越轻身，每朵云配上阴影。
And I was singing this old hymn.How the road is becoming wider and more glorious as we follow the Lord.
在那里阳光常普照，在那里没有眼泪，在美丽彩虹的尽头，众山林与天相连。
Amen. You all know this song.
Praise God.
I was singing there, but I was missing. I didn't have any audience. I was all
alone.
But I was really honest. Lord, you are wonderful. You are amazing.
我说主耶稣啊，我的手铐开了，脚镣开了。
I said, Lord, my handcuffs are I'm free, and my shackles are gone. You are amazing.
我感谢你给我自由，但是我的圣经
在哪里？ And I'm so grateful to you. You have set me free.But where is the Bible?
我要的圣经在哪里？
I really am serious, but I want to have Bible.
我相信你能开手铐，你也能给我圣经。
I said, Lord, if you are able to shrink me so much that I'm free from shackles, you can bring a Bible through that door.
我就是决定仍然要进食，
so、decided,
直到得到圣经。
I will continue fasting and praying.
我说主啊，如果有一本圣经陪着我，我可以一辈子在这监牢里，我都愿意。
And I give a promise to the Lord, if you just deliver a Bible, I'm ready to be rest of my life in this cell. Just send me the Word of God.
我深深地经历到耶稣一句话说：“孩子，我知道。”
And again, I heard Jesus saying, "My child, I know."
弟兄姊妹，你可能你生命中有哪些事情一直可能没有人知道，但是主真的知道。
I really want to share with you, brothers and sisters. There are certain secrets in your life nobody else knows. But remember, Jesus knows the suffering and the pain of your soul. He knows everything.
你向主的祷告，你的渴望，你的眼泪，你的叹息，他没有一样的。
Lord knows your prayers and how you have put your trust upon the Lord and the tears of your eyes. He knows everything what's going on in your life.
第二天早上，天
next morning
还不到上班的时候
before dawn, I heard that there's somebody who is coming towards me in the corridor, and I heard him shouting my name.
我告诉你，我的名字叫天上人，叫刘振营。
And this time, they also in the prison, they called me Heavenly Man. But there was something in his voice. It was different when he shouted, like he was very happy when he shouted, Heavenly Man. And he opened the three different set of doors into my solitary cell.
天上人,
I said, Heavenly Man.
我们昨天关于你的案情，我们这个做研究决定。
And he said, last night, the leadership of the prison have had a meeting, and we have decided.
我们尊重你的信仰。
And we will respect your faith.
我们送你一本圣经。
We will give you a Bible.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
他说他，我们尊重你的圣，我们给送你一本圣经，你好好的读读圣经。
We will give this Bible to you, and you have to promise to read it every day very carefully, and then repent from your sins.
等你读好了，读通了，你老实来交代你的问题。
And then you will reveal us to us all your crimes that you have committed towards us.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
那个监牢里面不是24个小时都读圣经，因为晚上是没有灯的。Now
I could not read 24/7 the Bible because it's only daytime. I had the little light coming out of the little hole in the wall. But every light moment, I was reading and memorizing the book.
只有白天透过那个小洞，外面射过来一点点的亮光。It
wasn't a lot, but I was able to read.
我真正。 想到这到底是做梦，这到底是真实的。
And this was so special that I did not know whether this all is just a dream, that I'm still asleep, and it's just a dream, because it was so unreal.
对神的敬畏，当他给我圣经的时候，我抱住那个圣经，我真正是整夜都是抱住那个圣经。
But it was still so real for me that when I was not able to read the Bible the evening and the night, I did not lose the Bible even for the second. I was squeezing it towards my heart, and I kept that Bible close to my body. And I was just waiting a new day to dawn that the ray of light would come, and I can start to memorize the Bible.
我感谢神一卷书就叫《启示录》，我掀开圣经的时候，我是。
And the Lord led me this way. Next morning, when the light came, and I opened my Bible, and I opened the Bible from Book of Revelation, and I started to memorize the Book of Revelation.
我就这样的，一章一章，每一个字我都不会放过。我这样的来把它读。
And I was reading very carefully every character, every word in the Book of Revelation.
然后我从启示录的第一章在。
I started from chapter 1 and I continued chapter 2, 3 throughout the book of Revelation.
当我读圣经，读到特别启示录这一卷书，我感受到是神量身定做，专程是为主我写的。And
I started to understand that actually Revelation, the book of Revelation, is in the Bible for me. It was a personal letter to me.
这卷书可能对美国有很多人没有办法读懂的。I
would guess that for an average American believer, Revelation is the last book you would read to yourself because you don't understand it.
这卷书里面，他开始我读的时候读到他爱我们，用自己的血，我才知道，不管人爱你不爱你，他爱你。
One of the greatest lessons I learned from the book of Revelation, how much Jesus loves his church. How much he loves me. How accepted I am because of Jesus.
就这一句话进入到我里面，耶稣爱我，你为我死在十字架上。
And I was so grateful. Lord Jesus, you loved me so much that you gave your own life for my salvation.
你爱我，你把我的罪孽赎回，你爱我。
And you released me from the punishment of my sins.
那我越往后头读，越开始对神那种渴望，那个认识越深。
And as I was moving deeper into the message of Revelation, I was just getting more and more excited about Jesus.
当我开始读到约翰最后的时候，我读到当主日他被圣灵感动。
And then I was reading this passage when John said that on the day of the Lord, the Spirit of God came upon me.
我就开始说神啊，我主啊，我就是因着你，我在监牢里面过日子，就是你的日子，我需要在这里被圣灵感动。
And I started to say and pray to the Lord, I need that your spirit will come upon me so that I understand my situation and my future.
弟兄姊妹，我非常感谢你们今天是主日，你们来到这里。
I'm so thankful that you took time on this Sunday, the day of the Lord, and you have come to church.
我也愿感动约翰的灵，不但感动我，也今天能够感动。
And I really pray that the same spirit that attacked John in the book of Revelation will attack you in this meeting today.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
你人在什么环境不重要，重要的时候，当你被圣灵感动的时候，一切都会改变。Because
it doesn't matter how deep is the mess in your life, if just the Spirit of God comes upon you, everything will be different and you will be changed.
Hallelujah. 我告诉弟兄姊妹，这是真实的。当我一拜天的时候，我想到了可能这一次又是要加多少刑。
And this was so real. So the coming 100 days, and I was just so hungry, and I wanted to receive more and more of the Word of God.
没有想到，按照上帝起初定那个时间，我四年到刑期满那一天呢。 竟然来一个警车说接你现在，我认为是不是要送哪个监牢里？没有想到把我送到我家乡来后，买一张票说你现在回去，你自由了。
I didn't hardly believe what happened. It was 100 days later, and the policeman came back to the prison, and then I thought now they are bringing me somewhere else to another prison, but they actually took me to the bus station and gave me a ticket and say go back home.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
那么我在监牢里最后的一百天，我到底看到了什么？
So what did I learn during those 100 days in the last days?
我到底听到了什么？
What did I heard the Spirit speaking to me?
我读的时候，我仿佛神对他教会说的话就是对我说的话。
Because I received every message that there was to any of these seven churches, I received they are all messages to me.
我告诉你，启示录这一卷书跟其他的书不一样，不是坐到办公室里，坐到摇椅上来写的。他真正是在到那个拔摩海岛上，神跟他说啥，他写的。
You have to remember that John did not write the book of Revelation when he was sitting in his fancy office with his computer. He was on the prison island in non-stop suffering when he write down the book of Revelation.
那时候写的时候，有些东西他不想写。说约翰，天上约翰，这个你也要写上啊！你写上。
And when there were certain things he saw, he could hardly believe. He could, I cannot write this. And the Spirit reminded, you have to write accordingly what you hear, what you see.
这也是真实的，是可信的。
This is real. You have to record everything.
那我特别读到启示录。
And the Spirit of God was really speaking in my heart, and I was moved in my spirit from the chapter 1 and onwards.
我是首先的,
I am the holy.
好像神不是在对约翰讲话，好像对我来讲话的时候，我是首先的，是末后的。 我是存活的，我曾死过，现在活主。
And no, he said that I'm the one who was and who is and who will be.
我拿着死亡和阴间的钥匙。
And I have the keys of Hades in my hand.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
当我读到这个地方时，我确定我不会死在监牢。
And when he said that I have the keys of death and Hades in my hand, suddenly I understood I'm not going to die because the key of death is in Jesus' hand.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
如果不是主的应，我不会死，所以我就欢喜快乐，我大胆，我知道权柄在他那儿。
And I started to rejoice. The Lord is in charge of even my dying. I don't need to be filled with fear. I was rejoicing in the Lord.
弟兄姊妹,
brothers and sisters,
基督徒, 信了耶稣的后, 并不是说所有的问题都解决了。
Remember this. As you become a believer of Jesus, it does not mean that automatically all your problems will be instantly solved. You may become sick. You may have other big problems in your life, and you will have.
你可能想到你这个小孙女，为什么她不到几个月怎么会出生了？啊，我们是神的儿，我告诉你，这个都与神的国度有关。
Maybe you have experienced that your little child has died, or the baby that won't even before was born, was dead. You have experienced so many things in your life.
我就读到神开始反复地读神说，在患难国度忍耐里，为了这个国度，你一定会经历压力，压力患难，你没有办法忍受。
And I started to believe, and I knew that to be unified with Lord in Jesus in this suffering and patient endurance that is in the kingdom of God.
我说这些话语是让弟兄姊妹知道，这是我个人生命中也是经历到这些。
And the reason why I'm sharing this with you this morning is because I have been there. I have experienced this myself.
我是17岁遇见耶稣了，今年58岁了。
Now, when I met the Lord, I was 16 years old, and now today I'm 58 years old.
我们中间有没有58岁的人?
Is there anybody who is 58 years old here tonight?
没有,
no.
感谢主，上帝就是给我预备的。
I'm so thankful that God has given me 58 years.
我虽然传福音这么多年，也经历过苦难。
I have served the Lord over 40 years, and I have gone through many challenges and difficulties in my life.
来到西方了以后，一直就是，我知道啊，当你要对西方人来讲，跟随耶稣是非常难的。
And I have had this uphill to climb when I came to the West, because the people did not really want to listen to me because I was pushing them to follow Jesus really and to become his disciples.
前一段时间，我有一段已经进入到一个人生低谷了。And
then a little while ago, I was brought to a very low point in my life.
你过去的经历不代表你现在跟随耶稣没有像当年的。And
you know, because to follow Jesus, you can never rely in the past. You just have to live with him today.
去年10月份。
In October last year.
10月底的时候。 我的妻子陪着我再到美国一直拜访不同的地方。
Now we had our twice a year tour in US, and my wife was traveling with us last October in US.
到聚会快要结束的时候，她突然间在她身上有那个白血症，也就是那个血癌呀。
Suddenly in that meeting, towards the end of the tour, suddenly my wife became extremely sick. And this sickness of lupus hit her body so that you could visibly see all the marks of that, what is happening in her body.
那是我第一次在监牢的时候，30年前她到监狱看我的时候，患上这种疾病。可是那个时候当时借起祷告，医生说这是一个白血症。
Now this wasn't the first time, because the first time I saw her having this was over 30 years before when I was in the prison. And my wife was pregnant with Isaac, and she came to the prison to see me, and she had the same sickness that time. But then after prayers and fasting for a long time, for almost 30 years, she haven't had any marks of that sickness.
直到去年的时候, 因为也上一代年龄了，去年那个就是这个颠簸的时间久了，突然之间爆发了。
So suddenly, after all these years, this autoimmune sickness hit with full power her body, and it was started to fall apart.
因为这个白血球红血，无论怎样在它的里面呢，我真正没有一点办法。
And there was,
for my, 我流出泪去找汤姆斯。
My, I didn't have any ways to help her because it is.A sickness in your immune system, and nobody knows how to deal with that. So I talked with the Brother Tyson.
我说汤牧师，我现在必须做出一个决定。我亮了红灯，我现在必须要退下来，专程来服侍我的太太。
And we decided that together that we will stop all the ministry, and I will return back home, and I want to be 24/7 there for my wife.Who was going through this living hell?
我知道全世界人都需要天上人云弟兄，可是他现在真正是没有办法，这不是儿女的责任，也不是别人的责任。
And I knew that there are so many invitations from all over the world for us to come, but I could not give this burden to my children. I said to Brother Taisto, I have to take my responsibility as her husband.
我和我的妻子，我们去见汤姆斯。我说，我承认我不是一个好的先生，我也不是一个好的爸爸。
And I was saying to my wife, I said, darling, I have not been a good husband for you. I have not been there for you when you have needed me most, and I have not been a good father for my children.Because I've been away or in the prison.
那个时候，他都每一天昏昏沉沉的，一睡睡那都睡不醒，一直在睡。
And my wife was in two different conditions. Either she was 24/7 awake in pain, or then she slept solid for several days and night nonstop.
后来
I didn't know what was going on in her body.
汤姆斯说：“云弟兄，在我所见着上万上万的牧师之中。”你是在我心中，我认为是最好的。你也是一个好的先生，是个好的爸爸。
Brother Un, among the tens of thousands of the pastors and the husbands and fathers I know, you are the best one.
我总是从内心深处感受到对儿女有亏欠，对太太
有亏欠。I felt that I owe so much to my children and to my wife.
那时候我给太太一个承诺，我说我爱你，我永远有时间，我也不怕麻烦。
And I said to my wife, I love you, and I always have time for you, and I'm willing to carry any problems that you have. I'm there with you for this.
那她回去了以后呢，突然间就送到那个加护病房里面。
And when we flew back to Europe immediately from the airport, she was brought to isolate.Total solitary ward in the prison in a hospital in Frankfurt. She was so much in this sickness. She did not recognize me anymore. Who I was.
甚至她连最关键的时候，她说：“儿子结婚没有啊？”
And then she started to ask me, "Do you know if my son Isaac have already get married?" She was totally lost.
我知道在那个时候，她的心呢，好像碎了一样。
It looked like her heart was completely in rest.
后来突然之间
But suddenly,
我早上就是开始读圣经的时候
I was reading the Bible in the morning.
因为我是已经决定就是要放弃所有的服事就是要陪
I had decided not to be involved in any ministry, so I had the times when she was sleeping, I was always reading the Bible.
神就对我很清楚讲话，为了国度，你必须经历患难。
And the Lord started to speak to me, for the sake of my kingdom, you have to be endurance to suffering in your life, entering into suffering in your life.
你进了神的国，必须经历许多的患难困苦。
And the Lord said, you have to, this is the nature of my kingdom, you have to go from one different difficulty at the time.
那我个人有一个敬虔的习惯，每一天早上我会差不多五点钟起来了以后，我会一直跪下来要读上几章圣经。
Now, I have already built up a personal practice for myself. Every morning before 5 o'clock, I wake up and I kneel down and start to memorize, read the Bible and pray.
那我那天开始来读到约书亚记的时候，从来没有想到的一件事情发生了。
And then one morning, I was reading from the Old Testament, from the book of Joshua, and the God spoke to me about this.
约书亚记第14章。
And this was the chapter 14 in book of Joshua.
都是提到那个当时耶和华神就是差遣摩西差遣迦勒要去窥探迦南地的时候。
This happened after Moses. Moses had died, and Joshua was taking the people of Israel to take possession of the land of Canaan.
这个故事大家很熟,
you know all this story.
可是读到加勒专心跟随神，我突然间就是神跟我说，你也是专心跟随我的人。
And as I was reading, the Lord said about Joshua, "You have been faithfully following me and serving me." And I felt the Lord is saying the same words to me, that I have been a good, faithful servant.
所以加勒找约书亚，那一天神人摩西啊，就是耶和华借着神人摩西所说的话语，你知道啊。
And then one day, Caleb came to see Joshua, and he reminded that you remember that Moses, how he promised that one day he is going to give me the hill country as the inheritance of my tribe. And suddenly I started to understand, oh, this is actually a promise that God has given to me.
他提到说，我现你看呐，我现在是85岁了，我的身体还是强壮的。
As you remember, that he said that I'm 85 years old today, but I'm still as strong today as the day Moses sent me out. And I'm as vigorous to go out to battle as I was then.
我读到85的时候，我突然间圣灵给我转换一下，58。
And when I was reading Bible that he said he's 85 years old, the Holy Spirit turned around the numbers and I heard him say 58 years old.
Hallelujah. 圣灵给我说你现在才58岁了。
And the Holy Spirit said you are now 58 years old.
加勒找约书亚要那个山地，把神应许那个山地给。Caleb
went to Joshua. He wanted to take possession of that mountain that has been promised, the hill country that has been promised for him.
圣灵开我的先窍，我的山地就是我的太太，她这个身上这个血癌红斑。
I started to understand that the hill country, the mountain that I have to overcome, is the lupus, the sickness of my wife's body.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我开始跳起来，红斑狼，你算不得什么，血癌你算不得什么。
Lupus, you are nothing. You have no control over my wife.
大山呐，你在所罗巴伯面前算不得，你在我身边也算不得。You
high mountain, you are nothing. You will be removed to the ocean.
耶稣说，如果我有信心，这个山可以挪开。And
I said, Jesus, you have promised. If I have faith, I can say to that high mountain, and it will be removed to the ocean.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我深夜中我就起来跑，从那个地下室我起来跑到我妻子身边。I
was in
我说你现在赶快起床。他说怎么？
It was early in the morning. I was down in my cellar of my townhouse, in my prayer room. I rushed upstairs to my wife and said, "Honey, wake up. Now the change have arrived."
我说神跟我说了,
and I said, "Lord has spoken to me this morning."
红斑狼血癌在他面前都算不得什么。
That the lupus and your blood sickness is nothing before the Lord.
那是实实是现实。
It is real. But it's not the truth. As we believe that we are healed because of his stripes. And I took hold, I said, "Honey, in the name of Jesus, stand up from your bed."
我告诉你，很多人都想不通啊！我深夜之中让他跟我起来一起啊，拉着他的腿是拉不动了。
And many people are upset about that. I'm really brutal to sick people. When I pull up my wife from the bed, and she had so her legs were so weak, and she was so much in the sickness.
我说你的冬天已经过去了。
I said, honey, the winter has passed by. Now it is springtime.
雨水已经止住了。
Now is the moment that God will heal you. Stand up.
Hallelujah.
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 好了，弟兄姊妹，我现在说，我不知道你的山地是什么。
Now I will close here, sisters and brothers. I don't know what mountain you are facing in your life.
我不知道这个城市的山地是什么。
I don't know what are the high mountains that need to be removed in this city or this society.
我知道马可有一座山，有一个森林，但是我不知道每一个人的压力到底还有哪些。
I know that Brother Mark has his own mountain and he's struggling with that every day, but you have your own.
但是不管你的问题有多大
，No matter how great the problems are in your life，
在从死里复活的耶稣面前
，Resurrected Lord Jesus before Him，
你的问题都算不得什么。
Your problems are nothing。
Hallelujah！
Hallelujah！
我们一同站起来。
Let us stand up together。Hallelujah！
我知道现在是你的时候。
Now it's time for you to respond。
在神的眼里。
Before the Lord,
他对你的拣选和呼召没有改变。
His calling upon your life is unchanged.
我的祷告上，主日今天感动你的心。
I believe that this in this day of the Lord, the Spirit of God is working deep in your heart.
约翰看到的。
The John saw.
我不知道神现在把你放到美国，现在这个美国这个情况，你看到了一个什么？
And I know that all of you are now looking upon your own nation of America, and you see different things and different challenges in your nation.
Mark, 你看到了美国的什么？
What do you see of America, Brother Mark?
中国有很多的山。
There are many mountains.
美国有很多的山，中东
也是一座山。Many mountains.
无论是政治、经济、文化，现在已经这个国家到了一座一座的高山在拦阻住你。
And there are a chain of high mountains like Himalaya before your very eyes.
神今天要呼召你成为得胜者。
But the Lord is calling you to become an overcomer, a victorious disciple of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
是第七个教会说话中要呼召得胜者。
And this call is called to become a church of overcomers, those who overcome everything.
你有多少人你渴望成为耶稣基督的得胜者？
How many of you want to become victorious with Jesus?
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
你渴望成为得胜者的人，不但举手走出来，我们要一起为你祷告。
If you want to be victorious, we will, Brother Mark, we need your
Hallelujah.
help. And just lead us, and we will release God's anointing and authority upon your life.
汤姆斯祷告 ，Hallelujah.
Mark will do that. Yeah, you just give it to him. Amen. So we will go and pray for people.
More than an overcomer, more than a conqueror.
Hallelujah.
Living this life of glory.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
Walking in His light,
help us to pray.
Overcoming power, the blood of Jesus Christ, the overcoming power, the word of my testimony, the overcoming power.Loving not my life into the death, Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. More than a conqueror, more than an overcomer, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. I'm so glad that I've learned to trust you. Jesus, Jesus, Savior, friend. And I know that thou art with me and will be with me to the end. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust you. Oh, how I proved you o'er and o'er. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, my precious Jesus. Oh, for the grace to trust you. Jesus, Jesus, the glory of the Father, sweep me away in the rivers of glory, sweep me away. In the rivers of your presence, Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. Thank you for the grace to trust you. Let the light of your glory shine through me. Let the radiant beams of your presence be seen. Oh, let the light of your glory now shine through me. Let the radiant beams of your life be seen. The light of your glory shine through me. The radiant beams of your life be seen in me. Let the light of your glory shine through me. The radiant beams of your life be seen. A light to the nations, a light of the world. Jesus Christ in me. Oh, Jesus Christ in me. This is the victory, oh, Jesus Christ in me. The conquering power that conquers, Jesus Christ in me. Just lift your hands towards heaven. There's a Holy Ghost baptism. Put your hands towards heaven and receive. Receive right now. Oh, lift your hands towards heaven. There's a Holy Ghost baptism. Just lift your hands towards heaven. Receive right now. Oh, receive, receive, receive. Oh, Christ Jesus is in you. Oh, receive, receive, receive. Christ Jesus, the overcomer's life is living in me. The overcomer's life, receive. Holy Ghost baptism, the fire of the Lord. Song Ling. The fire of the Holy Ghost. Song Ling. Song Ling. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost baptism, the fire. Just receive. Just receive. All the overcoming power of the Lord. Just receive. Just receive. Just receive. Just let your hands towards heaven. Just receive. You don't have to, you don't even know, just sing a song or know the words. Just receive. The power of God, the Holy Ghost, the power of God by the Holy Ghost is revealed right now to touch you. He's here right now to touch you. All you got to do is receive. Move past the things and the problems, the issue that may try to prevent you. And let the glory of the living God overshadow you. Just receive. Receive right now. The Pentecostal fire. Hey, is the rushing mighty wind. The Pentecostal fire's here to stay. Oh, receive, receive, just receive. The deeper you allow your compassion, the deeper you allow your passion, the deeper you allow the hunger and the thirst to be within you, the deeper the cry. It isn't how long you pray, it's how deep you pray. It's not how long you stand in His presence, it's how deep you're willing to go. Deep within, deep within, in the name of Jesus. Deep within. A wellspring springing and a river flowing. Deep within. Deep within your life. Let the power of God arise deep within your life. Let the power of God arise within you. Let the glory of heaven begin to show forth from your life like rivers of expression of divine grace. Jesus. 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 The radiant glory of His presence, the radiant beams of His life is here for the church right now, right at this moment in time in the year 2016, for the world to see the glory of the Son, the only begotten one. Just go ahead and receive. Go ahead and receive. God's got far more than for you right now. Just receive, receive, receive. Just receive. No greater name than the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus, Lord of all. The utterance of that name is the power that dispels every darkness, that runs out everything that is contrary to His kingdom. The power of the name that brings not only miracle life of the new birth, but miracle life in every area of your need. Right now, Christ Jesus, right here for you to receive. Right now, receive in Jesus' name. Just receive right now. Just receive. Just receive. Receive. Just receive. As many as received, He gave them the authority to be sons of God, anyone who would believe on His name, the power of His name. As many as received, He gave them the authority to be heavenly men, heavenly women, living out their life of Jesus in a heavenly realm, as heavenly, with a heavenly citizenship and a heavenly conversation, in a heavenly place, seated with Him there in the realms of His glory. Receive, receive. Receive right now. Receive right now. Chiamo non sere ne mandesi. Receive right now. Receive, receive, receive. Receive right now. Jesus. The wind of heaven. The wind of heaven blows on you right now. The wind of heaven blows on you. As those that are consecrating your lives to go with Father wherever He leads you, to do whatever He commands you, to be whatever He's purposed you to be in the kingdom, just receive the overwhelming glory of Father. I mean, there's no way that we can do anything that He's commissioned us to do without the empowerment that He gives. It's by His grace, by the empowerment that He gives, that we run this race, that we do what we do. So receive right now, because the grace imparted is available for you. Right now, Father's pouring out. Father's pouring out. Let this glory come upon you. Let this glory, let this impartation be yours right now. Let the response be in your life today like never before, that you're going to live fully for Him, that you're going to live consecrated to Him, that it's as though as you're buying a ticket to go to the mission field and never returning. And it starts right now, right here where you're living, right here where you're sojourning in your school place, your workplace, whatever place you find yourself in your community, you live fully for Him. No longer living for yourself, take up your cross. Jesus said, you want to be, I want you to be my disciples. You must deny yourself. You must deny yourself. Forget about what you know about you. Christ Jesus wants you to receive His life. There may be people standing here right now that you've never called upon the name of the Lord Jesus. Do it now. There may be people watching by the web. You've never called upon the name of Jesus. Do it now. All power and authority is in His name. The calling upon that mighty name, a transformation will take place in your life. A deliverance will come, an escape from the world, an escape from the darkness, escape from the sin, an escape from the things that belong to the pollution of this world. We'll go because Christ Jesus will come. Hallelujah. The light. Hallelujah. The Son of Righteousness shall rise upon you. The glory of God shall overwhelm you, and the power of God shall come upon you, and you'll rise and shine and begin to stand in a glory realm that Father has given by command in the name of His only begotten Son, Jesus. So just receive. Say, Jesus, I am yours. You are mine. Lord Jesus, You're the vine, and I'm the branch. Bear forth fruit through me. Let Your life be seen. Let Your light be seen. The radiant light of Your glory now. Holy Spirit, I will follow You. I will yield to You. I will walk like You. I will talk like You. I will think like You. I will act like You. I will move like You. I will be that one, just like the only begotten Son. To live the life of Jesus. To walk in the truth of Jesus. To walk in the light as He is in the light. Here I am. I will go. Send me. Jesus. I am Yours, and You are mine. I'm the branch. and you're the vine. Flow through me. Shut away with you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. The Lord would love to take his holy emotions and explode them in the depths of your deepest desire. What has ever made you cry? The loss of something very important to you, or the desire for it to come because it went so deep. Whatever made you laugh, the excitement and the rejoicing of receiving something that you so desperately needed or wanted or desired, and it finally came. That which you looked for and longed for. Father wants to take it deeper in your life. He wants to move you past the shell of despondency. He wants to move you deeper than the way that you've responded up to this point. I'm going to tell you, God has purposed that his presence, his life would flow out of the deeps, the very deeps, the very depths, the deepest depth of our being. Jesus used a word that was ultimately translated by a very archaic Greek word, kolia, out of your belly. Should flow rivers of living water, this spake he of the Holy Ghost. And very few people have come to know this realm. Major changes have to take place for you to know this realm. God invites us to come, but we've got to come hungry and thirsty and passionate. But in the depths of this realm, this word kolia, it refers to passions and emotions. The first place, the divine expression of God's unlimited glory would be seen through you and I. Would be out of this deep. It isn't so much about the volume of your voice. It isn't so much about the behavior of your outward appearance. It's just a deep expression of your passion for him that has been filled up with his own person, God the Holy Ghost. It's a realm that right now, if you raise your hands towards heaven, we're going to just one last prayer before we go. We want you to come back tonight because Brother Yun's going to minister to you and pray with you because there's a passion and a fire on the inside of him that needs to be lit up in America. There is a passion and a fire. I'm telling you, when he goes on vacation, he clears the place out, the hotel, everybody's going to get saved. I mean, that's just his mentality. This needs to happen, this evangelistic fire, this totally losing your life, not doing it your own way. And listen, here's the thing about it. I know that the pressures of our society and the world that is structured by Satan would impose upon us restrictions that God wants you to know how to bust through and break through. But right now, as your hands are raised towards heaven, there is going to be a grace that you're going to receive to know how to go deeper with God. No more just service conversations. No more casual conversations like you would have with an acquaintance. But a deep love and passion and earnest response like you have with the one that you're one with, that you love so deeply, that you care for the most. I break off in Jesus' name every hindrance. I break it off now in Jesus' name. Everything that would hold you back from this deep depth of Jesus Christ, this wonderful expression of God the Holy Ghost, to where you love him more than your life itself. That the word, that you understand that by the blood of Jesus Christ and by the word of your testimony and by the fact that you love him more than you love your own life, you find this wonderful realm of bringing an end to Satan being able to influence you and compromise you and conflict you and neutralize you at best and assimilate you at worst. But a glorious church now in you, just keep those hands raised for just a moment, just one more moment. A glorious church of Jesus Christ must stand up. And right now we proclaim in Jesus' name that glorious church will be revealed through you. You can't wait for another company to come.
You're the one standing here right now. You're the one right now that Father is pleading with and beseeching and begging to stand for him in an earth and a world that's been overwhelmed by the powers of darkness. So in Jesus' name, you receive. In Jesus' name. Right now, in Jesus' name, you receive the capacity, the ability to go deeper with him, to yield more to him, deeper. And I tell you, you listen to me, God does not need any help from us. He doesn't need any help from us. And many times it's not just even an outward expression. It's just an ability to receive. And what happens is you awake with his likeness. You find out, wait a minute, this is deeper than it was before. I need him more than ever before. I want to please him more than ever before. There's nothing that stirs me deeper in my heart than him. There's nothing that moves me deeper than the Holy Ghost. There's nothing that overwhelms me with greater joy, with greater passion, with greater purpose than his divine will. In the mighty name of Jesus, we commission you by the Spirit of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ to go forth as the army of God, to live out your life in the Holy Ghost, to walk in God and let your light shine the very life of Jesus Christ. The things that have been addictions in your life, the things that have been distraction in your life, broken now. I take charge of them in the name of Jesus Christ. There's no way that the enemy has right to come back into your life or to oppress you or to afflict you unless you give him permission. And Father wants you. That's the point of your will. That's the point of your will. Will you will the will of the Father? One day I said, Father, I'm going to live to do your will. Not my will, but your will. At that moment in time, I resigned my choice. I have no choice in the matter. That moment of time, we resigned our choice. Wherever you lead, we'll go. Hallelujah. Woo! And it has been a glorious life, and it gets better every day. Hallelujah. Well, listen, find as many people around you as you can to hug and tell them that you love them and bless them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Come back tonight. Come back tonight. Come on back. Press in. Don't make the Lord put you in solitary confinement so that he can spend some time with you. Voluntarily do it.
So when you are on the way out, we have a little table, and we have three different books there. You are welcome to take if you promise read and pray for back to Jerusalem. Just pick up a book or two about what's happening in Iran, the ISIS, and a testimony of one of the uncles of the church in China. And you are always welcome to visit our website, backtojerusalem.com. God bless you all, and see you tonight.
People, don't forget, it's a special privilege to have Brother Yun for two meetings. It's a special privilege to have him for two meetings. As much as he's in demand, so come back, bring somebody with you.